I'm S.S. Roy. Today's topic is boiler, and for mechanical second year students, according to the West Bengal State Council of Technical Education, according to your syllabus, classification of boiler, and there are various types of boiler, boiler mountings and accessories, and basic conception and comparison of stokered fired boiler, fluidized bed combustion boiler, pulverized fuel boilers, and boiler performance with simple numerical, and boiler draught, and calculation of chimney height, and boiler feed water treatment, and some modern high pressure boiler and its characteristics. Now, the most important topic, today's topic, is the boiler. Because you know, steam is extensively used for various applications such as power generation and industrial processes, some work interaction, heating, etc. With increase of steam in different engineering system, the steam generation technology has also undergone various development, starting from 100 BC when Hero of Alexandria invented a combined reaction turbine and boiler. So I am not going details. Now the topic is boiler. So what is boiler? The boiler is used to generate steam. At a desired pressure and temperature by transferring heat produced by burning fuel to water to change it to steam. Okay. Now, boilers are of many types. You may say, how classified are boilers? So based upon the orientation of the cell, boiler may be classified as vertical boiler, horizontal boiler, inclined boiler. Based upon the utility, stationary boiler. Stationary boiler means the boiler in the power plant, and portable boiler. The boiler is used in locomotive and marine. Now the next is the based upon the firing, externally fired boiler. Some example of externally fired boiler is Lancashire boiler and locomotive boiler. And internally fired boiler. Some example of internally fired boiler are Cochran boiler and Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Now next, based upon the fluid inside the tube, fired tube boiler, Cochran boiler, locomotive boiler and Lancashire boiler is the example of fired tube boiler. And water tube boiler, Babcock and Wilcox boiler, Lamont boiler and Benson and Hedges boiler. So fired tube boiler means according to the flue gas and water circulation, fired tube boiler means flue gas passes through the tube and surrounded by water, it is called fired tube boiler. In case of water tube boiler, water inside the tube surrounded by fire, so it is the water tube boiler. Now next is the based upon the fuel used, solid fuel, like coal is the solid fuel, liquid fuel, it may be petrol, diesel, kerosene, and gaseous fired fuel, CNG, LPG, whatever may be. Now based upon the circulation, natural circulation and forced circulation. Natural circulation means by nature air entered into the combustion chamber and burning takes place. In case of forced circulation, there are two types of forced circulation. One is forced draught, another is induced draught. Okay, if we combination of two, it is called balanced draught. It will be discussed later. Now next, basic conception and comparison of stokered fired, fluidized bed and pulverized fluid boilers. Now stokered fired boiler are classified according to the method of feeding fuel to the furnace and by the type of grate. The main types of stokers are chain grate stoker or traveling grate stoker and spreader stoker boiler. Now here we discuss only chain grate stoker. So this is the schematic diagram of chain grate stoker. It is the chain grate, it is the stoker chain, and it is the coal hopper, and it is the feeder. From coal hopper is the feeder, with the help of feeder you spray the coal, and burning takes place like this. Burning takes place, and it is the chain gate stoker, and it is the ash hopper, and from air, from FD fan, enter into the chain gate stoker, and ultimately enters in the furnace chamber. Okay, so this is the schematic diagram of chain gate stoker. It is a very simple and easy. Now next is the most important topic, is the in modern power plants, pulverized coal fired boiler is used. Pulverized coal firing ensures complete combustion of coal, thus ensuring higher efficiency of steam generation. If the coal is pulverized, then the volume of the coal, is surface area of the coal, is remarkably increased, so we can get greater amount of heat from this same amount of coal. Okay, so this is the schematic diagram of the pulverized coal fired boiler. So it is the raw coal bunker from which coal enters into the gate, and it is the feeder from the preheated air from the flue gas for coal fired is entered, and it is the pulverized mill in which pulverizing takes place, and it is the separator, and from the separator it is into the induced draught fan from which coal enters into the burner. Pulverized coal enter into the burner, and it is the preheated secondary air. So it is the primary air, it is the secondary air, enters into the burner, and burning takes place, and this is the furnace. So it is a simple diagram. Now next is the fluidized bed combustion, FBC. is a combustion technology used to burn solid fuels. In its most basic form, fuel particles are suspended in a hot, bubbling fluidity bed of ash and other particulate materials like sand, limestone, etc., through which jets of air are blown to provide the oxygen required for combustion. The resultant fast and intimate mixing of gas and solid promotes rapid heat transfer and chemical reaction within the bed. FBC plants are capable of burning a variety of low-grade solid fuels, including most types of coal and woody biomass, at high efficiency and without the necessity for expensive fuel preparation like pulverizing. Now next is FBC reduces the amount of sulfur. You know, FBC, fluidized bed combustion, reduces the amount of sulfur emitted in the form of SOx emission. Limestone is used to precipitate out sulfate during combustion, which also allows more efficient heat transfer. There are two reasons for rapid increase of FBC: a liberty of choice in respect of fuel in general, and number two, a low emission of nitric oxide and fuel, and the possibility of removing sulfur. FBC burns fuel temperature approximately 750 to 900 degrees Celsius. So there are two types of FBC. One is pressurized fluidized bed combustion, and another is bubbling or circulating fluidized bed. Okay. Now it is the simple diagram, most simple diagram. So it is the fluidized bed combustion, and it is the fuel, that means fluidized bed particles enter into the combustion chamber. It is the fluidized combustion air enter, and it is the water enters into the tube, and steam comes out, and it is the combustion gases out. So it is the simple diagram of the fluidized bed combustion. Now next most important topics is the boiler mounting and accessories. Okay, boiler mountings and accessories. You know, boiler mountings and accessories are necessary each and every boiler. Boiler mountings is situated on the boiler cell, and it is used to safeguard the boiler cell as well as to protect the boiler cell. Okay, and boiler accessories is used smooth running the boiler cell, as well as to increase the efficiency of the boiler cell. Okay, the most important boiler mountings are water level indicator, safety valve, water level indicator, safety valve, safety valve, fusible plug, pressure gauge, stop valve, feed check valve, blow up cock, manhole and mud box. All are mountings. Okay, all are mountings. So water level indicator, you know, water level indicator, each and every boiler, there are two types of water level. There are two water level indicators are there. Water level indicator indicates how much water present in the boiler cell by standing in front of the boiler cell. You can ascertain how much water present in the boiler cell. Now safety valve. You know, safety valve is used in the boiler cell to protect the boiler against high pressure. There are various types of safety valves. Most important are deadweight safety valve, spring loaded safety valve and lever type safety valve. Okay, in boiler there is lever type safety valve is used. Okay, if the boiler pressure exceed the limit, then it escapes some amount of steam, and to maintain the pressure inside the boiler within the limit. Next is the fusible plug. Fusible plug is the most important mountings. The fusible plug material, the melting point of the fusible plug material is less than the boiler cell material. If there is some reason there is no water inside the boiler cell, maybe there are two water level indicators due to some reasons. Water level indicates that plenty of water available in the water, but due to some reason there will be no water in the boiler cell. So in that case, fusible plug melting point is lower temperature than the boiler cell material, so fusible plug material melt and some amount of steam escape and to protect the boiler cell against damage. Okay. Now next is the stop valve. Stop valve, it regulates the flow of steam from the boiler. Okay. This is generally mounted in the highest part of the boiler cell and perform the function of regulating the flow of steam from the boiler. Stop valve generally has cast steel. Okay. Now next is the feed check valve. Yeah, it is a non-return type valve. It is the non-return valve, and from the feed pump, water enters into the feed check valve. If the pressure of the pump is higher than the boiler inside pressure, then it opens and the water enters into the boiler cell. Now next is the blow-up cock. Okay, blow-up cock. It is used periodical cleaning by discharging the water and sediments from the bottom of the boiler. Okay, it is called the blow-up cock. And next is the manhole or mud box. Manhole provides opening for cleaning, inspection and maintenance purpose. Mud box is a collection chamber for collecting the mud. Okay, now next is the boiler accessories. The accessories is required in the boiler cell to smooth running the boiler as well as to increase the efficiency of the boiler cell. The most important accessories are the superheater. Because you know, boiler never generate superheated steam, because steam generate above the surface of water. So superheater is used to superheated the steam from boiler. So it is a type of accessories. And next is the economizer. Economizer, the name indicates, it has no disadvantage, all are advantage. It is also a heat recovery device, okay, in which feed water is heated from the heat available with exhaust gases. So this is the economizer. Next is the air preheater. Like economizer, it is used for recovering the heat going along with exhaust gases by the air before being sent to the furnace. Okay, so it is the air preheater. Next is the feed pump. Feed pump is used for sending water into the boiler at the pressure at which the steam generation takes place. It is generally three types: centrifugal type, reciprocating type, and injector type. Okay, so this is the feed pump. Now next is the most important topic. In your syllabus, you know the is the the boiler. You know the boiler, that is Cochran boiler. So this is the actual diagram of the Cochran boiler. You know, this is the actual diagram of the Cochran boiler. You just draw in your workbook. This is the speed, this is the grate, this is the firebox column, and this is the Cochran boiler. So next boiler is in your syllabus. Next boiler is the Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Okay, this is the Babcock and Wilcox boiler. So the scheme is very easy and simple. Babcock and Wilcox boiler, all description is there. Okay, now third type of boiler is in your syllabus. This is this is the Lamon boiler. Okay, this is the Lamon boiler, and this simple diagram of the Lamon boiler. You can see clearly in this picture. So this is the end the topics today, and the next class will be the boiler performance. Okay, thank you.